All tickets for Traverse Day are gone. Admission was capped at 50,000. It is now sold out. Alyssa Carapriest is at the track right now, live with NYRA's president, Chris Kay. Hey, Alyssa.
Hey, Cody. Yeah, so a big day for the Saratoga Racetrack. Kind of making history today. This is the first time you guys capped the Traverse and officially selling out. How does it feel?
It feels great. So we for a variety of reasons, safety reasons as well as enjoyment reasons, we said we're going to cap it at 50,000. We announced that last Thursday, and we sold out at 12:38 today. 28,000 general admission tickets sold in over a week.
And I remember last Friday when we spoke, we had about 50% of those tickets left. So just in a matter of a week, they are all gone now.
They are. There was a phenomenal response from the great racing fans of New York and here in Saratoga in particular.
What preparations are you making now? Tighten security, extra staff, I'm sure. Are you prepping now for Traverse?
We are indeed. And so we have a great new team. We did a lot of things differently this year at the Belmont Stakes Day. We've taken all those lessons we learned and processes we put in place and now employed it here for the Traverse.
Are you taking any steps now, assuming American Pharoah is going to be coming, are you prepping for that if he does choose to come?
Indeed. So, for example, we are talking about additional security for the horse, for the connections. We're taking into account all of those things, as well as making sure that our 50,000 fans on site have a great time that day.
I also wanted to mention that we really have lucked out with the weather throughout the entire meet. And of course, yeah, knock on wood, I told you I got the worst luck. But tonight, a few showers, but the storms passed to our south. It really hasn't been too bad. But so far, the weather, I'm sure, helping with attendance so far.
The weather has been incredible. And there are two things about it. Number one, obviously, if it rains, people won't come or are less inclined to come, but we've had great attendance. Mm-hmm. The other is that when we have rain, sometimes we have to take races that were planned for the turf tracks and put them on the dirt track. And when that happens, sometimes we'll lose some of the horses that would otherwise compete, reducing field size. This year, we've been remarkably fortunate, and we're very grateful and very appreciative of the wonderful weather we've had to date.
Yeah.
And hopefully it continues.
Yeah, fingers crossed on that, that the weather continues to cooperate for the rest of the meet. Chris Kay, thanks for being with us tonight.
Thank you.
Cody, I'll send it back to you. We've got more coming up this next half hour.